Good morning, dear students. I hope you are doing good. Today we are going to learn lesson 18 exercise, the old man who came back to life. I hope you understand the lessons. Let's go to the exercise. So, learning grammar, write the plural of these words. So, here we have a singular form of words. So, for that singular form, we are going to write a plural form. So, first I will explain what is singular and plural. So, singular means only one. One pencil, one book, one child, okay, one classroom. So, more than one, that is we call as a plural form. You see here, so here only one boy standing, that is singular form, that is child. So, here four boys are standing, that is plural form children. So, those words we are going to write plural form of these words. So, child for that plural form children, child for that plural form children, and oof for that plural form oofs, and ox plural form oxen, and bus buses, loop loops, life lives, and watch watches, donkey donkeys, city cities. So now we'll learn the singular form also as well as plural form also. Once again I repeat it, singular means only one, plural means more than one. So let's go to the next exercise, that is who, which, relative pronoun. So, in this exercise, we are going to learn relative pronoun. So, relative pronoun means it is related to the noun. So, relative pronoun, it is related to the noun. Before the noun, we are writing a relative noun. Before noun, we should write the relative noun. So, here we have a four sentence. So, in that sentence, we are going to write the relative pronoun. And first one, there was a farmer, dash had many children. So, there was a farmer, dash had many children, that is who. So, here we have a two pronoun, that is who, which. So, for the first one, we have to write who. So, now, there was a farmer who had many children. There was farmer who had many children. So, this is the boy, dash is to blame. So, this is the boy which is to blame. Otherwise, this is the boy who is to blame. So, here who. Second one also who. Which is a wrong relative pronoun for the second sentence. So, this is the boy who is to blame. So, this is the boy who is to blame. So, the correct relative pronoun is who. And the book dash my father gave me is good. So, the book which one my father gave me, that is good. So, the book which my father gave me is good. So, which book he or her father gave to them, that is good. And last one, the lion dash is in the cage is very strong. So, the lion which is in the cage, it is very strong. So, here which. So, relative pronoun means is related to the noun, and relative pronoun always we are writing before the nouns. And here we learn two relative pronoun, that is who and which. Next exercise, we can make opposites by adding the prefix this to some words. So prefix means that word we can add before the word, that word we can had before the word, that is why we call prefix. So example, appear is the word. Here the before the word we have this, so the this we called as a prefix. So prefix we have to write before the word. So now disappear, so now the answer is disappear. And Take words from the following two which we can add prefix. So here we have a five words. So among these five words, which word we can add prefix, that we have to take out. Okay, so here dislike. So like, before like we can add prefix, that is dis. So here the first word we have to add dis, so dislike. And second one agree, so disagree. But eat, deceit. So this, before this word we could not add a prefix, so that is cross. We have to make a cross in that. And believe, we can add prefix dis. So here we can dis believe. And here color also we can add dis. So here dis color. So now we learn, for those words we can add prefix and those words we cannot add prefix. Okay, prefix means before the word we have to add, that is called prefix. So now use is had and was. The first one is done for you. So here use is had is a present tense. So this sentence we have to had is are. So for the singular pronouns we have to had is, for the plural pronoun we have to had had. So likewise here also in past tense, for the singular we have to write was, for the plural we have to write were. So now first one is done for us. There is a farmer. So there is a farmer. Farmer is a third person singular, that is why we write here in simple present tense is. So there is a farmer. And what dash you doing? What dash you doing? So what are you doing? So you, second person plural. So now we have to write the are. So what are you doing? There dash nothing to be done. There dash nothing to be. Nothing, it is also under the third person singular. He, she, it, nothing, we don't know. Okay, so here is. So there is nothing to be done. So they dash friends. Friends is a plural. So we should write the are. So now we done the simple present. So now let's go to the past tense. So now what, there was a farmer. Same sentence. There dash a farmer. But we have to use only these two verbs, was and were. So there was a farmer. Okay, and what were you doing? That action is completed, so we have to use were. And there was nothing to be done, and they were friends. Now we know where we have to use is and are, and where we have to use was and were. For the simple tense, present tense we have to use is and are. For the past tense we have to use was and were. And let's listen. So now how the both kids and both people can communicate each other. That, so it is hot now. He is telling it is hot now. So right now, present time he is talking, it is hot now. For that the girl is telling, it was not hot in the morning. So she is talking about the morning. So morning when they come out, that time it was not hot. It was a normal climate. But afternoon, now in the present, he is telling it was hot now. Okay, so here the father and son, they both are talking. See, so the father is telling the student, his son, father, the son is telling to his father, the students are coming from the school. The students are coming from school. See, the students are coming from school. So after the schools, they are coming to home. They are coming from school. So for that he is telling they were going to school in the morning. Yes, if they were going to school morning, then only they will come back from the school. So while we talk to each other, otherwise with your friend, your father, mother, so likewise we can talk. And now we have to write more sentence to use these words, which, that, who. So here we have a four sentence and this side we have a four sentence. So use this, we have to create a new sentence. So the first one, he is the boy who meet me. So it is the one sentence. He is the boy who meet me. So this is the boy who meet me in the morning or yesterday. So again we can make the, this is the man who came here. The same person, okay, this is the person who came here. And this is the pencil which he bought. This is the pencil which he bought. That is the fox which killed the lamb. Okay, so now we create the first sentence new. Okay, use this help of which and what. Okay, and find as many words as you can from the bubble. So here we have a bubble, two bubbles. One bubble done for us, that is environment. From that there were find new words. So iron, which one we are used for making clothes neat. And on we know, men also we know. And here one more bubbles we have. To help of this management word, we have to make a new three words. So this one, first one is man, first one is man, and second one is age. So first one is M-A-N, man. First three letters we made as a one word, and next three letters we made another word, that is age. And for the next G-E-M we made another word, that is gym. So now use these bubbles we found the three new words, that is man, age and gym. So in lesson 18 exercise we learned, okay, first relative pronoun and prefix and how we could create a new sentence and how we found the new words. Okay, I hope you understand the exercise. Okay, learn well and be safe at home. Thank you and have a nice day.